Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online training course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to set up the chart of accounts in QuickBooks Online. To follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also find a link below this video to our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. The chart of accounts is the backbone of your bookkeeping and accounting system. All of the transactions that you enter into QuickBooks are categorized behind the scenes using the chart of accounts so that financial statements such as your profit and loss statement or income statement can be generated. For the purposes of this video, we will use a fictitious company called Paul's Plumbing. As you view this video, think about how the information might differ for your business. QuickBooks Online will create a chart of accounts list based on the industry that you selected when you set up your account. A few of the accounts that QuickBooks will automatically create for you are accounts receivable, accounts payable, inventory asset, sales tax payable, and retained earnings. If you want to keep track of something that is not on the default chart of accounts list, you will need to create a new account. Some things to consider when deciding if you need to create a new account are: what items would you like to track that are not currently on your chart of accounts list? For example, if you want to keep a close eye on the fees that your bank charges you, then you could set up an expense account for bank service charges. What accounts are on the list that you know you will never use? For example, if you don't sell products, then you would have no use for an account that tracks shipping and delivery fees. Once you have decided what accounts you would like to add or delete, you are ready to make the necessary changes in QuickBooks. We will use our fictitious business, Paul's Plumbing, to walk through how to add, delete, or modify the chart of accounts list. In the written step-by-step lesson, you will find a quick reference chart to assist you with setting up new accounts and to give you the big picture of what's happening behind the scenes in QuickBooks. Just click on this link to access the written instructions for this lesson. Paul would like to track the income that he makes from his residential customers separate from the income that he makes from commercial customers. Let's set up these two accounts for Paul's Plumbing. To begin, after you have logged into your QuickBooks Online account, click on the gear icon located to the left of your company name and select the chart of accounts from the dropdown. The chart of accounts list will display. To set up a new account, just click the blue New button. And here are the fields that we need to create to set up a new account. Category type, if you click the dropdown for category type, is going to be income. This lets QuickBooks know how we want this particular account to be set up. So we'll select income from the dropdown here. Detail type. Typically, you will select sale of product income if you sell products, or service fee income if you sell services. So we'll select service fee income here. And in the account name field, we want to put residential income. And then the description field typically can be the same as the account name field, or if you have a much more detailed description that you'd like to indicate here, you can do that as well. So we'll go ahead and put services sold to residential customers for our detailed description for this account. Our options for saving this information are: we could just save and close this if we were done setting up accounts, or we have the option to save and create a new account, which will save this account and it will keep the screen open so that we can set up the commercial income account. So that's what we'll do. Select save and new, and then we'll go ahead and set up the commercial income account. So again, category type is income, detail type is service fee income, and we will call this commercial income. We'll go ahead and save and close this time since we are done setting up our accounts. This will take us back to the chart of accounts list where we can see the new accounts we've set up. There's our commercial income account. And then if we scroll down, we will also see our residential income account. You should delete accounts that you do not plan to use. This can be helpful because the account won't accidentally be used in transactions, and it makes your chart of accounts list much more manageable. You should never delete an account that you have already used in a transaction. To delete an account, you are going to click the arrow to the right of the Run Report link and select Delete. In the next screen, QuickBooks wants to confirm that you actually want to take this action. Once you select Delete, there is no automatic undo button. If you accidentally delete an account, you will have to add it back again. So we'll go ahead and say yes, we want to delete this account. QuickBooks allows you to modify an account at any time. To modify an account in QuickBooks, you want to click the drop-down arrow to the right of Run Report once again and select Edit. You want to make sure that you do not change the category type if you have already entered transactions using this account. If you do so, it could impact your financial statements. So we'll go ahead and modify the account name to be Office Supplies. And we'll go ahead and include that in the description as well and save our changes. That wraps up the section on how to set up the chart of accounts in QuickBooks Online. To access this course or any of the others in the series, click this link. For a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online, click the links below this video. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.